Hey guys, Ben from the Night Vision shop here. Today we're going to be doing a little bit of an unboxing of the NightRide Scout 640-35. So this is a vehicle mounted thermal camera. Comes in this nice hard case. 640-35 comes with a hard case. All the other models just come within a cardboard box, nicely packed away. But the advantage of this, much easier to travel with and get around without damaging what you got. So let's have a look inside what comes with it. First off, you're going to have your usual manuals that come with it, a little bit of information about how to do a hardwired connection. A hardwired connection is something that is only available on the 640 models. And your little quick start guide here as well. Being a 640 model, there's going to be a few other things in this package that aren't going to come within the 384. We'll talk through those individually. So here's your Ethernet extension. This is for doing a hardwired connection to your phone or your iPad, laptop, however you want. A USB-C cable. Once again, this is just for your hardwired connections and for Android users. Apple users won't receive a cord, but we'll talk a bit more about that further into the video. Your adapters for doing the hardwired connection, and a 12 volt piggyback with some extra USB ports on it, which are also going to be required to make this hardwired connection. What's included with all the NightRide products is you're going to have a wall mount adapter. So if you want to power this at home from a general power outlet, you're able to get that sorted without needing your vehicle. Two remote controls. These are handy as having a spare one, or you can have both two users running the camera at one time. You're also going to come, add a little bit of grease, which is for any maintenance further on down the track. It can be help greasing up the pan feature, and a few rubber strips underneath, which is for a different way of mounting it to the roof. Last but not least, the unit itself. NightRide 640-35, as the name suggests, 640 sensor and a large 35mm lens on there for you. Now you see what we've got here, let's have a bit of a look at how to mount it up onto the vehicle. Alright guys, so something you are going to want to consider before you're mounting up your NightRide is the terrain that you're going to be driving on. Now NightRide offer a nice mat underneath. This covers where your six magnets are. The mat allows a nice strong grip on the top of your car without causing any damage to it. If you peel this mat away, you're going to be able to see where your magnets are. Now your NightRide Scout is going to come with these rubberized sticky discs that can stick directly onto these magnets. Now if you're driving at speeds above 30 kilometers an hour, or you're going to be going off-road with your vehicle, NightRide do recommend to use these. It just allows a slightly better magnetic connection to the car while still protecting your roof. So the best part of mounting your NightRide Scout with the magnetic base is how simple it is to attach to the roof of your car. All you got to do, drop it on, and you've got a super strong grippy hold to the roof there. You got to think about the cable. Where's it going to go? Some people will run it through the front window or through the driver's door. Problem with that is that if you're constantly getting in and out of the vehicle, it can get tangled up and caught in the way. Best way we do it, pop it through the back door here, shut your door, that way if it's a cold winter's night you can keep the windows up, stay nice and cozy in the car while you're looking for anything out there. So once you've got your camera set on the roof, you're going to come into the car. You'll notice that you're going to have two plugs on your 640 versions. On the 384, you've just got the single plug. So you want to plug this 12 volt into your 12 volt port to power the unit. Don't worry about the Ethernet cable for now, that's for a hardwired connection. Once it's plugged in, make sure you have a little red light coming up on the side of it, and that's just going to confirm that you've got power coming through. So now we've got the NightRide Scout mounted up on the roof and with power, you want to grab your remote and just make sure that everything's working as it should. Always best to keep the aerial out in the remote and make sure that the switch is up in the on function. Once you're here, hold a button, make sure you're getting that nice pan The NightRide Scout does have a full 360 degree pan on it. This will just keep going around. Make sure your tilt's all working well. Tilts up, tilts all the way down. This is looking ready to go. See, take your lens cap off. This is gonna help you see better. And you'll see this little red light on the side here. This is flashing at the moment, which means it's waiting for a Wi-Fi connection. So let's get that hooked up. All right. Now that we've got the NightRide Scout mounted up on the roof and all powered, we're working to look at the Wi-Fi connection. So jump on your phone or your tablet, enter into your Wi-Fi settings, turn your Wi-Fi on, and what it should come up is NightRide. So this is going to be your connection. Click on that. Each unit comes with a card with the password written on there. Enter in that password. I'll try that again. And connect away. So on most devices, it's going to come up that it's checking for the quality of your internet connection. What your phone's trying to work out is, because the NightRide's not actually giving you any internet, if this is going to be a suitable connection. Of course, we're going to want this connection, so I hit always connect. And this way in the future, it won't prompt me each time. Now that we've got the NightRide connected without internet, you want to go into the NightRide app. This is something you can find through the App Store. And as you'll see, you have your connection here. With your remote, you can give it your turns and see everything that's going on. Once you're on the app here, it does have a few extra features. So you can, through this, control your zoom. This is unlimited, but keep in mind, the more you zoom in, the more pixelated the picture is going to become. See a little bird down on here. We've also got your color palettes. So you can run through those. And you see, this is going to help with the calibration of the unit. And you've also got your recording function down here. Tap on that, it's going to start your recording. You've also got settings up here. Click on that, it'll take you through to some more in-depth settings for the unit. There you have it, that's your Wi-Fi connection. So we want to do a wired connection, which is available on all the 640 models. There are a few other parts that you would have seen come in the box that you're going to require to get this sorted. So to start up your wired connection, you only need to use the piggyback for the 12 volt. This allows an additional USB charger, which will help power your phone and also to power the adapter. So you plug one end into each. To afford you a little bit more space, not having to have your phone down in the center of the console, NightRide will supply an Ethernet extension cable. Plug this one in here, the other end into your adapter, and that's going to complete the cabling flow. Once you've got all that set up, simply plug it in, just like usual. It is going to be ready to plug into your phone. Now we've got this hardwired connection. There's a slightly different way of accessing the image. So what you want to do is go down into your settings, turn flight mode on. This is going to be able to help find the device. So once flight mode is on, you're going to want to go into your internet, go to 10.4.10.4. Once you go to here, this is going to find that live stream flow. While you're connected here, you are able to turn flight mode off now, and this is going to keep the data rolling flow. You can also, if you're in flight mode, move from this connection into the app. You do need to connect through the internet browser first to be able to access it on the app. Once you got to this screen, everything will be running just as normal. Mount your phone up and you can drive along and see you in the night.